Hey guys, welcome to day 8. We have 3 more days to go, or 3 more videos to go, should I say, including this one, to reach our $1,000 goal for the funnel that we created together. And you know, I've really been distracted, as you guys can see, with this funnel right here. But regardless, let's go ahead and dive directly into the funnel that we built. So I just want to kind of show you guys the update. Kind of cool to come in here and see these kind of numbers. You guys can see kind of where we started from and how we've scaled up. We actually will probably burst through another scale again. We're just letting our ads optimize and stuff right now, which is why the sales kind of went down a little bit today. We killed all the unprofitable campaigns, and now we're going to start slowly scaling the profitable ones. But anyways, guys, let's kind of dive over here into our funnel. So you can see here we had, let me just go ahead and pull this guy up real quick so we can see where we are. So I have looked, obviously, and seen that we did do a couple of sales today, which is good. So we're at $515.95 sitting on the funnel. We sold 5 memberships, which we still sold 7, which I'm still upset about that. I really hope that we don't come, you know, $80 short of our goal, because then I would have hit it, some memberships. But anyways, another thing I don't like is we haven't sold any upsells, which is aggravating. But anyways, guys, let's go ahead and come over here and look at the ad account. So I'm going to kind of go over to a lifetime view of these. So you can see the ones we made. Okay, so this is kind of hovering there at $42, $37, $18. So, and you can see here, these actually didn't even spend that much money on here. So I'm not sure why, if that's having like an issue delivering or what. What's going on there? But the first thing I'm gonna come over here and look at now is we're gonna look at our ads, and we're gonna kind of see if we kind of take out the ad sets here. Let's look at our highest impressions to our lowest impressions. So you can see this ad right here. This is going to be, remember, our cost per acquisition. I believe we said to break even with the membership was like around $26-$28, and we decided at $16, I believe, was our cost per acquisition to actually to be profitable on the front end, which is what we want to do. We never would continue running an ad, especially with our campaigns, because we run into cash flow issues. And you know, so essentially right now, especially with our accounts, is PayPal taxes us. So we don't use PayPal, but even our merchant accounts we use, they will tax you. Like, for example, we have, like, it's 6 figures. We have 6 figures in reserves right now, where they hold a percentage of our sales. So because of that, we really have to stay cash flow positive. So for example, if we were to, you know, close down shop today, we need to get like a $200,000 payday check in 6 months. So like they hold your money, they hold our money for 6 months. I think it's like 15% of our sales up to 500 grand. I think so. Those are kind of issues that you run into when you really start scaling, which is good to know when you're first starting off, because the last thing you guys want to do is come in here and get used to this. And then, you know, like, oh, well, I'm just going to pay, you know, if you have a $16 break even on the front end and you're over here like paying for $20-$25 purchases, knowing you're going to break even in 14 days from now, and then you're going to make profit in the future. The issue with doing it, of course, is cash flow. So, you know, you can't ever really scale. When that happens, unless you have a lot of cash and liquid cash to work with, then by all means, do what you want to do. But I'm just telling you guys from experience that you guys want to stick to being profitable on the front end of the funnel. So, anyways, here, so if we kind of look through here, I'm just going to kind of look through here and see. So you can see here, this is, we got 6,000 reach, which is plenty. I'm gonna actually come over here to performance and click, so we can kind of see a little more metrics over here. These are all really great relevancy scores, which I'm really happy with that. Our CPM right here is really gone. It looks like they're lower. Like, we're getting some really good CPMs here. But it's aggravating when I get my purchases on the higher CPMs. I hate that. I wish I could just get purchases with the lower CPM. But now what we're gonna do is, before I ever kill anything. Like, I like how this one looks. $5, $20 purchases. I'm going to let that kind of stay on and see how that optimizes. 2 purchases right here, $62 purchase. That's definitely not good. And before we kill it, though, I'm going to go ahead and look and then make sure that nothing crazy is happening here with our CPMs. So I'm going to come over here to our CPMs and look and see kind of how it's going. So, I mean, it is trending down here. You can see it's went from 20 to 19 to 18. You know, really something to, like, really be cautious of to know. Because, I mean, you know, even though we're getting really high conversions here, like, this thing can drop down, like, back to, you know, $14 or even maybe, like, $10, right? This thing would continue to follow through here. We might see $10 CPMs, which would bring our impressions up by double, okay? And it would make this purchase price cut in half. However, it's still a super high purchase price, even if it was to be cut in half. So for that reason, we're going to kill this ad. I'm going to look at this ad real quick too, see which one that was. Reveal the truth. Okay, reveal the truth. It's getting killed. And what one? Stay out of harm's way. Okay, LF8. So we have... So these don't really have enough impressions really to kind of look at. But we can kind of look through here and see our click-through rate. So our click-through rate right here on this one, 0.76. That's not too good. That one's not looking too good, but we'll leave it running for now. This one, same thing here. We have $11 spent, 886. Like, none of these have enough for me to really look at, but I will just for the sake of this video because it's going to be a really short one today. We're not going to really be doing much of anything. So our CPM is really low. I do like our CPMs really low here, you know. But, you know, this one's just as effective. Even if this one's $22, the fact that our CPM is almost three times that means that, like, you know, it's still like it's $24 anyway. Because if you guys do the math here, you know, if you have a 0.76 click-through rate, then, you know, we're getting just as many clicks on this ad as we are with this ad. And you can see here, like, for example, we got 8 clicks, we spent $8. Now, 8 times 3 is 24, right? So if we were spending around this amount, we would get 24 clicks. So actually, even though this ad has a much higher CPM, the fact that the CTR rate is at 2.06, more people are clicking through, it makes this a better ad. Even though we killed it just because we didn't get any purchases here, we weren't having, you know, we were having 3%, like we had like 3.65%. Click-through rate. Like, I wasn't happy with this, so I killed it. But the fact that this has such a low, this the fact that this one right here has such a low CPM of $7, okay? Like, even though this, since it has a $7 CPM, we're going to leave it running just because if this can start to optimize and Facebook can get a little smarter for us here, that we are going to do some damage with this one. So, I like that one. So, we have default conversions here. So, $12.62. CPM 1.8581. This is a good ad to kind of watch here to see how that relevancy score 10. This is great. This one right here, I think we have two purchases for 11.25 here, and once again a 3.88% click through rate. And this is what's aggravating about Facebook is, like, we have such a great click through rate. Our CPM should be like $7.70, right? Like, this. That's realistically what it should be. If that was the case, just so you guys can see how powerful this is, like, when you can get Facebook to cooperate with you and they give you a $7 CPM and you have a 3.88% click-through rate, when that kind of power happens, now I want you guys to think about this, okay? If you do 25 divided by 3, it's about $8 and some change. So, you know, literally we could be getting three times the amount of traffic to this ad if we had this CPM. So if we had three times as much traffic, we would have had 6 purchases, okay? 3 times 2, 6. And then our cost per purchase would have been divided by 3. You know, it would have been minuscule. It would have been, you know, $4 somewhere in there. Just how powerful it is to be able to understand your analytics on your ads. These are kind of things that I look at and I take into consideration before ever killing an ad. And before I ever kill an ad as well, I will always look at the chart and kind of see what the pattern that the ad has done, especially with the CPM. Like, CPM is really kind of everything. That's like the most important thing that I look at. Now, obviously, purchase, because purchase is the highest thing, but, you know, our CPM, if our CPM is just continuing to skyrocket up, the ad ads can become less and less profitable over time. But anyways, yeah, so you guys can see all these ads here. We're going to continue to let these run out right here. And I also see here if we had any ad sets here in here that has spent a bunch of money that we didn't get any purchases on, which we haven't. So everything that we spent, you know, a significant amount of the budget on actually came through with the purchase. And you can see today we didn't spend our full amount. We only spent around, yesterday, we spent $235. You know, we had another negative day, obviously, off the rip, because if we come over here, we only did like $200 of sales. Let's see what we did here. So okay, still doing this. Let's go to the 9th. So you can see here on this day that we did about $200 in sales, right? But the cool thing is we sold 2 memberships today. So what that means is, you know, $200 in sales, but, you know, we will make that money back through time. So like around month 2, month 3, we would essentially have been profitable today, which, you know, allows us to keep being able to run data. We had a 2.07% conversion rate today, which isn't good. We like to be around a 4 to 6%. So, you know, most of this really has to do with the traffic that we're running. Like, Facebook hasn't really figured it out yet with this item, what exactly we're looking for, obviously. But I really feel I have the faith in Facebook to, like, to figure this out for us. So I'm going to keep running the traffic to it. And, you know, like, once the traffic gets good and we get to that 4 to 6% conversion rate range, you know, then we'll be able to really, hopefully we can find, of these ads right here, hopefully we can find maybe 3 ads to run at $40 a day. Like, after this 10-day challenge is over, my goal is hopefully to end up in this campaign with, you know, 3 or 4 different ads. So we get 4 times 40 a day, or we can go out and spend $160 a day and, you know, hopefully bring back in around $300 to $400 a day on that, like a 2x ROI, just to where we're breaking even on the front end of the funnel to just keep selling memberships. This will be one of those small winning products that we'll just keep this thing running. You know, you can keep these little small winning products running for a very, very long time. Obviously, if all y'all come in here and copy this product and stuff, then I won't be able to keep it running for a very long time. But, you know, this is not a winning product, so I wouldn't copy it if I was you guys. but, you know, we're just kind of going through a process here. But anyways, I'm not going to turn anything off today because, you know, nothing really got to spend what it should have spent through these days. So I think that's probably because of the lookalike audiences. Like, maybe it kind of took a while for them to optimize. And then usually Facebook's kind of really slow sometimes to start off our campaigns. So, until tomorrow, we will come back in here. I'm actually going to go ahead and scale this campaign right here down. Since we're not doing too well with conversions here, I'm actually going to, even though we need $1,000 in sales, I'm not trying to lose a bunch of money doing that. So I'm actually going to scale this down 20%, which will take it down to 80. So I usually scale in 20% increments and no less than a 24, 48-hour period. So it's probably the last time that you will see me scale this down. But now our daily total now is going to be 40, 80, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's going to be 200. Is that right? Yeah, I'm so bad at math. 40 times 7. 280 plus 80. So I guess I think yesterday I was like way off. So our daily spend tomorrow should be around $360 still. And again, I'll come in here at lunchtime tomorrow and try to check it today. I wasn't able to get in here at lunchtime because I was not in town today. But yeah, anyways, guys, this is pretty much it for this video. So I'm sorry this one's kind of a shorter video, but hopefully you guys got to really take a look inside the analytics, and I was able to help you out in some sort of form or shape or form.